Take a look at the Finder. The best analogy for your computer is a giant filing cabinet. You can see what's in it by clicking on the Finder icon right over here. You can also go up to the File menu and say New Finder Window or press Command N. The Finder window shows you what the contents are on your computer. First, the window itself. I can pick up anywhere in the gray bar and hold my mouse down and drag the window where I want it to go. Down in the corner, there's three diagonal lines. I can pick up those lines and resize the window to any size that I would like it to be. If I click the green button in this left corner, it will resize the window to the smallest and largest sizes that I've used. If I click the yellow button, it will minimize and tuck itself down onto the dock, and I can click on it again to bring the window back up. Clicking the red button in the corner will close the window altogether until I open up a new one. Now, continuing with that analogy of the Finder as a filing cabinet, all of your files are stored in files. You can think of the places as drawers. There's a drawer for your applications, and a drawer for your documents, and a drawer for your pictures. Then, in your documents folder are hanging folders containing more manila folders or documents. And I can create a hierarchy so that all of my similar files are grouped together in a folder. This icon view, though, isn't that handy because now that I'm here, I can't see how I got here, and I have to hit my back button to go back up again. So instead, I actually prefer this list view. All of my folders now have triangles next to them, and when I click on the triangle, it will show me everything in my documents folder, and I can open and close my subfolders. And you can see that they're all indented in a hierarchy, so I can easily see the contents. This view is also nice because it shows me the date, the time of a file, its size, and what kind of document it is. This next view is called the column view, and it's wonderful because when I click on a folder here, it shows me its contents in the next column. And I can easily see the hierarchy and the path from where my files are. These columns are also resizable. I can make them larger and smaller as needed. Now, when I'm looking for a particular file, let's say I have a spreadsheet in sample files, but I'm not sure exactly which one of these I need. There's a feature called Quick Look. I'll click one time on a file, and I'll hit my space bar. And it will open up a quick look window showing me the contents of that file. I can either click on the different files in the folder to see them, or I can use my up and down arrows and scroll through them. And when I've found the file that I'm looking for, all I have to do is double click to open it. Now, it's up to you to keep your files organized. So when you go to save a file, you need to tell it where to go. Now, unfortunately, the first time you open up a window, it's going to look like this, and it's going to say, hey, I'm going to save this file in my documents, but it doesn't give me any control over that location. If I click this innocent blue arrow, it spreads out into a Finder view, so that I can actually intentionally put my files where I want them to go. Instead of just in my documents folder, I will put them in Excel, and I can say I want to go into sample files and then into class files. But if I want to create a new group of files, I can also add a new folder anytime. And when I click create, I can then put my file in that folder, allowing me to organize my own files. When I'm done with my quick look, all I have to do is either click the X or click the spacebar to close it again. I can also make new folders when I'm in my Finder window by going up to the File menu and choosing the second option, New Folder. I'll name the folder and I'll hit return to accept the name, and then I can put anything I want to in it. You can even move your files around. I can take this folder, for example, and put it inside that folder. That way you can organize your files even if you already have a big mess. What I'd like to show you is called Cover View. When I'm clicked on any folder, I can see its contents in a visual way by clicking on this fourth button right here. It will show me a picture of each file. It'll show me the contents. If there's a video in there, it'll even allow me to play the video. This way, I can find the file that I'm looking for without having to open every single one and see if it's the right